Good evening. We begin tonight with extraordinary video that's emerged from inside one of the helicopters involved in a deadly crash on the Gold Coast. It was filmed by tourists who survived the horrifying ordeal and provides a much clearer picture of how the two aircraft collided. And we warn some viewers may find these pictures confronting.
A joy flight over Southport turns into a terrifying nightmare. Pilot Michael James tapped on the shoulder by a passenger, seemingly unaware another helicopter was on a collision course. The rotor blades smashed through the cockpit, glass shattering over passengers. Everyone on this helicopter survived. On board, four tourists from New Zealand and a woman from WA. The pilot managing to land with catastrophically damaged controls. Watching it all unfold from below, Ron and Tracy Drevlak. They were walking their dog just 10 minutes before the horror unfolded, almost directly above them. With no concern for his safety, Ron was one of the first of many who raced to help.
Seen it all happen, watched it fall out of the sky and watched it hit the ground. And the noise and the thud of it hitting the ground, I cannot get it out of my head.
He sprinted to the destroyed chopper, now on its roof. Videos recorded from the sandbar are too distressing to show. The scene was frantic.
You in earth? Good. Oh, well, go help. Go on, do what you can.
Six people were inside. Four could not be saved, including British couple Ron and Diane Hughes.
The first person I saw was, I think it was Ron. We cut the seatbelt, we pulled him out and pulled him away, but it was a lot of panic, a lot of people yelling.
Ron then ran to the other side of the mangled wreck.
That's when I heard Winnie. She was just screaming.
Fuel was leaking onto her, so rescuers grabbed buckets, whatever was nearby, and started pouring cool seawater inside.
Don't worry, I said, help's on the way. I said, it's only water. I said, we're just trying to dilute the fuel.
This must be traumatic for you.
It is. It's really traumatic.
Yeah. Alongside 36-year-old Winnie, her 9-year-old son Leon. This is him being pulled from the wreckage by the pilot of the second helicopter. Michael James had somehow managed to land his crippled aircraft on the sandbank.
Surviving pilot, he was very dazed and confused. I don't think he could actually believe what had happened.
His friend and colleague, Ash Jenkinson, was dead.
He said to me, he said, oh, is Ashley all right? Is he all right? Yeah, I knew he was gone. It was, yeah.
Horrifying, really horrifying. No words, really.
Also inside the wreck, Vanessa Tadros. This was her and son Nicholas moments before they took off. Her injuries were so severe she couldn't be saved. The 10-year-old remains in hospital. Husband and father Simon watched it all unfold. Posting on social media, Nicholas is in a very serious and critical state. I'm asking for all your prayers to bring my little man back to me. As tributes continue to be laid here at the memorial at Southport, right on the Broadwater, friends and families of the victims are coming to terms with their grief and the shock of what happened here on Monday.
It was a very emotional day. There was a lot of stories being told and there was a lot of tears shed.
On the Broadwater today, helicopters hummed overhead. Too much for Dusty Olliman, who was a close friend of pilot Ash.
It's a bit hard watching how the choppers in the air at the moment.
Yeah, I'm just thinking that. It's a bit upsetting.
Today, air crash investigators arrived at the Gold Coast University Hospital to speak with family and possibly the surviving pilot.
We need to know what was going on. We have one pilot who has survived. He will give an account. There is no way that this tragedy should ever have happened.
It is raw and confronting, this whole story, and of course the vision that has just come to hand for 7 News showing inside the chopper that did manage to land, and all of those people on board have managed to survive, though many are still in hospital, shows, you know, what exactly happened. It was just a calm joy flight over Southport. The pilot is tapped on the shoulder to be warned what was coming, and of course then the collision happens. And now that sort of vision and many others, the Australian Transport and Safety Bureau, Sam, they'll get a hold of that and really start to try and piece together exactly how this whole thing has unfolded.
It's just chilling. Thank you, Steve.